Okay, number two, we're asked to convert this equation relating polar coordinates to an equivalent equation relating rectangular coordinates. And so we have to be on the lookout for things like r cosine theta, because that's x, r sine theta, because that's y, r squared, because that's x squared plus y squared, and tangent theta, because that's y over x. Okay, so we'll see what we do. We start off here with r equals 1 over 2 plus cosine theta. And to get started, we can get rid of the denominator because we typically don't like those. So we can multiply both sides by 2 plus cosine theta, distribute through the r. And if I look at this, I see an r cosine theta, and I'm on the lookout for an r cosine theta because that's x. So I've got 2r plus x equals 1. And now I've mixed my variables, which is really bad form, but I'm going to move that x over like so. And I've got an r, and r squared is plus or minus x. Excuse me, r squared is x squared plus y squared, and so r is plus or minus x squared plus y squared, so I can put that in there. Now I've got everything in terms of x's and y's, and then to clean this up, what I can do is square both sides. I get plus or minus 2 squared is 4. I take the square of a square root, I get x squared plus y squared, and then here I get 1 minus x squared. So to clean this up, I get 4x squared plus 4y squared. I'm going to multiply this thing out, 1 minus 2x plus x squared. And so I subtract over the x squared, I get 3x squared. Add over the 2x plus 4y squared minus 1 equals 0. And so that's the equation, the general form of a quadratic equation, which would give rise to a conic section. So that would do it then for number 2. Okay, number 3, we're asked to convert an equation which relates variables in rectangular coordinates to one relating the variables in polar coordinates. And to do this kind of conversion, it's same kind of thing as before. We're on the lookout for certain quantities. We can always replace x with r cosine theta. We can always replace y with r sine theta. We know that x squared plus y squared is r squared, and y over x is tangent theta. So we're on the lookout for these guys. So I start off with my equation, x squared plus y squared minus 6y is 0. And right away I see the x squared plus y squared, so that's r squared, minus, I see the y, that's 6r sine theta, is equal to 0. And usually what we want to do is solve r as a function of theta if that's feasible. And here I've got an r in both of these terms, I can factor it out. And so here I get r is either 0 or r is equal to 6 sine theta. And I think when I think about which of these equations is going to give me the same set of points as this is, I know from college algebra this is going to be a circle. In fact, I could complete the square and find out where the center is. R equals 0 is just going to describe the origin or the pole. Okay. This is going to be something that's going to describe more points than just the pole. And in fact, when theta equals 0, pi, or any coterminal angle to those two things, we're going to get out r equals 0 again. So this is sort of a degenerate answer, and we sort of ignore it. This is the equation we're after. So that'll do it for number 3.